So we are now writing down, in fact, let me write down here itself, pre-workshop. The budget. And they say about 35 teachers, we'll put this at about 35 teachers, average. It may be slightly less and more. Actually, if you ask me, the correct way of engineering costing is not like this. The correct way of engineering costing is to do a minimum fixed cost, because even if you have 10 participants, those minimum fixed costs you have to have. You already engaged a colleague who has done some godagiri work, you have to honor him or her, you have to pay the institution some money for, when you are conducting this lab, management cannot use half the lab if it is, even if it is free for something else. So the lab costs, like the hall rental, whatever, all those costs you will have to spend. There is a fixed budget. Then there is a per candidate budget, actually. The number of candidates more, the budget will be more. I would suggest that at this stage, let's agree on one thing. As a thumb rule, 3 lakh rupees budget per center is approved, assuming that there are 35 candidates. If there are more candidates at some place and if there are less candidates at some place, we will work out details with the individual centers to contract or expand this appropriately with full understanding, not one way from mine. Is that a fair this thing? Okay. Mukta, we had put 20 lakh rupees per center in our budget. 2 lakh rupees per center in our budget, that has just become 3 lakhs. Okay, that's, well, you go for 10 minutes, this is what happens, so now don't go anywhere. Okay, but I have taken the responsibility of convincing the Mandarin in Delhi that when the main project starts, the budget will be 3 lakh rupees per center. Because all of us conclude that if 3 lakh rupees are given, then the 2-week physical engagement can be done, even supporting teachers' stay and food. And in fact, there is an agreement that if teachers come and stay at that place, the participation will be greater. And we have agreed that the travelling allowance support will be limited to 1,000 rupees, irrespective of what is the actual travel cost. So this will encourage people to go to nearby places if they really have to travel. If they are on vacation, that's a different matter. So this is agreeable. Okay. So, paisa dundo abhi kidhar, this is your responsibility. I'll help you. Yeah.
So, what about those institutes who will not be able to arrange the accommodation? They don't have
arrangement.
We have to look for the
like
institute doesn't have the facility to accommodate
the. The question that he is raising is what to do if institutions do not have accommodation? I will tell you, sir, that for Mumbai colleges, it will be best to stick to those teachers who don't require accommodation. That means, please don't admit participants from South India as he was suggesting. Let all South Indians go to Bhopal. You say, I will take people from Borivali, Virar, Bandra, Dadar, Matunga, whatever, whatever. Is that okay? Right. So, we will not make residential thing compulsory. We will say that these people, wherever this organization can be done, depending upon the facilities available, the remote centers will be making arrangements for stay and food.
They can contact the respective
to find out whether they are accommodation. In fact, better still, on our website, we should clearly state which RC has accommodation and this and which RC does not have. So that it will be very clear. So South Indians will not go to him. Or North Indians also for that matter. Nasik se bhi nahi aayega koi, kaisa aayega if you don't have accommodation. But how do you handle then if you... The kind of budget that we have. As I told Hariharan that day, the DA rates in Delhi are such that either you can stay in Dharamshala and remain hungry, or you can stay on footpath and eat some chana bhatura once a day. Period. Nothing. It is nonsense. Yeah. No. He is talking about those colleges who do not have that accommodation.
Okay.
So that's the problem. Yes. We have in IIT Bombay used hostels for accommodation for faculty members when we did not have guest house accommodation. It is possible. It all depends upon how you can organize. But that reminds me, if I have to print the first version of brochure and send it, every RC must tell me accommodation and food facilities, yes, no. Accommodation. What I mean by food facilities is lodging and boarding in that sense. If that is yes or no. So the feedback forms that you have not submitted it. Uska niche, acha, I'm sorry, there's a problem because we generally collect anonymous feedback because we expect a lot of criticism. And people are hesitant in writing critical comments if their names are also written there. So the feedback form does not indicate that. But is there any other mechanism?
They should write the head of the institution name.
Arey Baba, then they can't write it on the feedback form. So do me a favor. Just get a blank paper circulated. In that blank paper, just write the name of your institute and yes or no. We will assume that yes or no is related to accommodation. As simple as that. But this we should have. No. That is your decision, na. I can't impose. But I have to inform participants. Yahan pe jagah hai, yahan pe nahi hai. I don't mind so that you can discuss it with your management and find out whether, as someone was suggesting, hostels could be used, etc. But this has to be like ASAP. Because if I have to meet the deadline of 10th May, I'll keep other material ready, but against the list, I will print whether accommodation available, not available. And that I would like to get feedback as early as possible, preferably by within next 2 or 3 days. Okay, let us also assume what is the default in case I don't get information from you. No, I understand all that. But what I'm asking is a simple question. Let us say I want your feedback by 30th. So I will write it here, in fact. Accommodation availability. April 30th, midnight. All deadlines are midnight, because they are all email deadlines, okay. We will not count the delay caused by our servers at this end. The dispatch timestamp should be before 30th midnight, okay. What is the default? If I don't get anything, because I am going to print the name of your institution anyway. So what is the default? Yes or no? No is the default. Professor Kannan, since you have come, he is, by the way, the principal investigator of the National Mission Project. I am merely a co-PI. So you see how I transgress my authority. Without even asking him, I have announced this. We just agreed that at 2 lakh rupees per 2-week course is not feasible unless they charge something more. IST does not want us to charge, and also charging will be differential. So to remove all that, we all discussed and agreed that if the per center funding is 3 lakh rupees, then they will be able to accommodate everything, including limited travel grant of up to 1,000 rupees, assuming people will be coming by nearby places, and stay and food for all the people where they have accommodation. Where they don't have accommodation, we'll appropriately reduce the funding to that center. So the cost of the project has just gone up slightly. That's the only thing I wanted to say. Okay. So you were observing on the budget something you
said. So 3 lakhs is fine.
See, my PI is so cooperative. He has approved. End of the matter.
So what do you do when people
don't have accommodation, where are they going to stay and what are you
going to do? No. So here we discussed that. That is likely to happen in Bombay colleges, for example, or main city colleges. However, in most such cases, all the participants will be from local colleges. So just like even today, we have people from our friends from Don Bosco and others who are not staying in the guest house because they are commuting. So if we have such teachers, then that will cost less. And we will accordingly arrange the budgets for this. But if you approve this, that is fine. Anyway, I had anticipated that and already told them that it's approved. Only Kalpana is troubled because she has to find some money actually that she'll figure out. She has been doing a good job of it. Actually, she has a very funny reputation. Earlier, we got some funding for conducting such workshops, etc., which had this thing. But by charging money to participants, because these were CEP courses, she actually made money instead of spending money. So we had to conduct 10 extra workshops to spend all the money which she saved. But that was small amount, so it only proves that she is a good manager, but not good spender. Anyway, so this is agreed then. This is the pre-workshop thing. There is something additional that we need to do in the pre-workshop, and that is our own interaction and continuous updation. So we will have to do the, coordinators Moodle. I will call it coordinators Moodle for this CS101, whatever name we give. I will set this up by May Day is a good target. 1st May, and we will try to ensure that all of you have the same user IDs that you have given. You remember those user IDs, right? But you would have set passwords afterwards. That would be a problem perhaps. So I don't know whether I can get that decoded password file from them. So what I will do is, to begin with, I will set your user IDs with the same password and then you change it. So your user ID and your password is same as your user ID. So first time you log in, then you set it. Initially, you will all be registered there as students. I will be registered as a teacher. And we'll use it as a collaborative site to get these things done. So you can see all postings and so on. Like my CS64 course, the information system course, I'll organize the files and other things so you can see notifications, etc., whatever. And a discussion forum that we'll start on this Moodle will finalize the detailed syllabus. That is the most important thing, for which I think the understanding was that I should put up a format in which you will fill up these things for everything, and we'll compile all of that. Okay. So detailed syllabus, then schedule. Workshop schedule. Similarly, every activity that we do for promotion, for example, we send these brochures to, let's say, 1,000 colleges. Then there will be a separate document listing the names of all those 1,000 colleges to whom we have sent this. The brochure itself will appear on the Moodle. And in fact, since we have decided to do a collaborative work, I will put the draft of the brochure. Kalpana, can we put a deadline to this? Since 10th of May, we have to send, that means by 7th of May, they should be discharged. So let us say the first draft of the brochure will appear on the 1st May itself. I can see that, because I only issue commands. She is the computer which has to execute the algorithm. So it's a problem. No, but I was just joking. We'll do that. We have no choice, by the way. What I would submit is that if you have any observation on the brochure contents, please be very quick in giving the feedback. Because we would like to, please understand that the logistics of printing 5,000 brochures will take a minimum of 3 days, then dispatch. So we'll do a parallel processing of collecting addresses and whatever, but we'll also like to post these things in time. So this is priority. All other things we'll have 4 weeks duration, almost 8 weeks duration in between. And what we will do then is, even the detailed activity that we need to undertake collaboratively for preparation, this itself we can arrive at through some discussion. So I'll put up some schedule of, detailed schedule of what weekly thing, you I think raised it, somebody raised it, what we should do every week kind of thing, roughly. because each one of you will have different engagements. Now exams will start, correction work will come, but doesn't matter. Some people will may not be able to do work immediately, some people will be able not be able to do later. Overall, I think as long as these 20 people cooperate, we should be able to get a good thing. Okay, then there is a post workshop activity. The post workshop activity, which I had not written, we have said that 22nd July the teachers will go back. We are saying that the teachers must work for 2 weeks. I am presuming that the first year courses will not start before middle of August. That is universally true in the whole country, unfortunately, except for some places. But even if they start, we will assume that the teachers will work from 23rd July to something like 7th August. And we will expect that they will continue to contribute in the course Moodle that we have set up. Okay. I still do not know whether I will be able to make a distributed Moodle by that time, which means that the teachers going to your RC, their submissions, etc., are visible to you and also visible to us. We will figure out how to do that. But we will set up a single Moodle. We will probably call these batch 1, batch 2, batch 3, or batch Coimbatore, batch Pune. No, Pune means batch COEP, batch Vijetia, batch Amruta 1, batch Amruta 2, whatever. We can figure that out. I think I will go by Professor Ranade's experience in setting up batch-wise Moodle. The composite Moodle will be available to us. Okay. And then from 7th August, now this is the hard work for you. Will one physical week be sufficient for you to collate and put all the material together which they have submitted? This will be there on the same Moodle site. You may only have to add more comments. You may just have to say, okay, this you can include, this you cannot include. Like questions and answers particularly, that which they give. We want a second opinion, whether the wording of the question is correct, whether it is meaningful or not. If you ask me, the contribution to the question bank will be the most crucial, which need to be quality checked. The contribution to slides and other things, we can simply include them with attribution to them, so that even if it is a lousy slide, everybody will know his slide is not good. And during the course, we will tell them that please be very careful of what you submit, because your name is going to be associated with it for the rest of your lives. So I think people will take care, but still some editing kind of thing at your end would be useful. So how long will it take? We have said 1 week's work, but 1 week's work when you are free, you can do work for one full week, but then you will be busy by that time. So should we say not 1 week, not even 2 weeks, but 1 month, with again some kind of a prodding by Kalpana every weekend with a list saying this week only these people have submitted something, etc., etc. So 7th August to 7th September, we will say consolidation by RCs. When should we release the web portal for the subject? Because we will require a minimum of 2 months' time to do post-production editing of all the material that we have collected. I am not talking about the consolidation of this material. So if the course ends on 22nd of July, then August, September, October, at least 3 months. So that means our post-production editing we do want to spend time in this, by the way, because we want to make it the best. This is the pilot, so everybody will view this. So post-production editing will end only by October end. When is Dashera or Diwali this time? Traditionally in India, Vijayadashmi is regarded as the best time to launch something new, right? So let's say portal launch.
That comes sometime in September.
Well, we'll figure this out. This is slightly post-production, so we can take some pangas. But to ensure that we actually stick to some timetable, I want to announce this publicly.
28 September.
Very good. 28. Yes. Okay. Just tell Samir the bad news. He just lost 1 month. 28th September. 28. Yeah. And post-production editing should therefore end by 25th September. Good. We have a whole timetable shown up. Any other important point that we have missed, please?
We are giving 2 weeks time for the participants to prepare the material, questionnaires.
Yes.
Is the time sufficient?
I will tell you why. Because immediately after that, they will end up starting to teach the course. And therefore, like you, they will also become very busy. Further, there are two principles that I would like to state or restate. You may know. One, work expands to fill up available time. So if you give more time, generally we take more time to do the same work. Second, unlike you, who are in the thick of things right from today and you are going to be there because you are coordinators, many teachers will be able to do a better work when things are fresh in their mind. If you ask me, ideally I would have liked to conduct this as a 4-week workshop, where the remaining 2 weeks also teachers remain there and actually do this work collaboratively with discussing with each other. Since it is not feasible because of the cost, otherwise you will ask me 3 lakh rupees more. And the teachers will not come for a 4-week engagement. Nobody wants to be away from family for 4 weeks.
So, we can tell the participants
simple, if they don't submit.
So that
assignment will have to be done. That is good point. That is the part of our activity here. Which assignment should be given to which teachers from which place? I am not of the opinion that we should restrict this topic to this center or this topic to that center, but I am rather saying that for every topic, something must come from everyone. So if you read my theme paper, I have given what kind of expectations from teachers are there. As long as they do it for something or the other, you want to ensure that everybody does not give questions only on pointers. So therefore, we will have to decide, depending upon the number of participants, we have to give them topics and say on this topic you work, on this topic you work, on this topic. But it's a good point that you raise, and Kalpana, we should do something about it to decide on a strategy and announce it to all RCs beforehand and then RCs to implement. And we will not do anything before putting up that decision as a suggestion on the Moodle, all of us commenting on it, and then the coordinators or IIT Bombay deciding, saying, okay, go ahead. So that we don't do anything which we will have to later on have a problem. But that's a good point. Anything else that we have missed? Anything else that is significant?
Can we add an assignment,
sir? Sorry?
Can we add an assignment from our
Sure. In fact, by the way, this collaborative content contribution need not start only after the workshop ends. It can go on during these 2 weeks also. In fact, that will be useful. You ask these teachers to make some contribution on a topic today. So you get 35 questions every morning. What is the harm? You get those 35 questions, maybe you reject most of them. It's a good experience for them also. See, framing questions is not very easy, by the way. So let people gain some experience as assignments. In fact, we'll keep some assignment as framing questions on a topic. That's a good idea.
Is there some background work that could be needed? For instance, we came up with a sort of syllabus which we thought would work for an entire
Yes.
But let's say I go back and I see that in Anna University something else is followed as 101.
Yes.
Please,
very wonderful session. Please keep your eyes and ears open. If you have friends in faraway places who are not represented here, please ask them proactively as to what is the subject or something like that. We will also be attempting to collect this. If you get to see anything, if something is substantially different and orthogonal, we can't do anything about it. Because we have agreed that it will be C, C++. But if there is something different, like in terms of units definition, emphasis definition, please try to collect that, because we want to make this as useful as possible. Fair enough. Okay. So we conclude this with a lot of promise to each other to do a lot of work over the next, whatever, 3 months, 4 months. But believe me, if this experiment succeeds, the nation is going to remember us as the first ones who did this. You know, that stature nobody can take away from us, and that is why it is a responsibility that we do a good job. But imagine if 1,000 teachers, many of you run your ME programs, right? You look at the quality of ME students that you get today. If that quality becomes twice as good, wouldn't you be happy? That's the point. Okay. We are personally looking at large number of very better prepared students coming to our M.Tech programs, by the way. So, Yeah, please.
Sir, as we are talking about the last date of registration for the participants, it may happen that till the last day people may not come.
Correct.
Like after 30, if you are given the permission, only 20 people are on the last day, and the same day of the registration day can come 10 more people.
The answer is always yes, but informally. I will never say this. For such people, what you should do is, you should take care to inform them that you are seeking permission from the course coordinator at IIT Bombay. I am telling you in advance that I have said yes already, and I will never say no any time. But I will have to say yes to a specific request, and then only you do that. Otherwise, what happens is, you basically what you are doing is, you are not giving an appropriate weightage to those who applied in time and got registered. So these extra people have to go through some anxiety of 24 hours one day or something like that, where permissions are being sought and obtained. It is the same thing as IST. I have no doubt in my mind that IST will approve that 4-week workshop, but technically I have to say it is likely to be approved. Till I get the approval, then I will post it on the website. Okay then. So with this, we conclude this course. Thank you very much.